العلم أشراف مطلب وطالبه لله أكرام من يمشي على قدم. العلم نور مبين يستضيء به أهل السعادات والجهال في الظلم.
طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وسيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما، اللهم آمين. So inshallah, in the previous lesson we studied the difference between al-mashi'a and al-irada. We learned the difference also between al-irada al-kawniyya and al-irada al-shar'iyya, the legislative irada and the universal irada or the universal will of Allah Azza wa Jal. We also, some of you also took the exam and the test, and alhamdulillah, congratulations to all of you who took the test. And inshallah, every few weeks or every few lessons, there will be similar tests bi-idhnillah ta'ala. In today's lesson, inshallah, we will continue with the next mas'ala or the next issue, which is ithbatul mahabba wal mawadda lillahi ta'ala, affirming for Allah Azza wa Jal al mahabba, affirming for Allah Azza wa Jal love for His awliya, for His servants and slaves, in a manner that is befitting His majesty. The author rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, وَقَوْلُهُ وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ فَمَا اسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ وَقَوْلُهُ قُلْ إِن كُنتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وقوله فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. وقوله إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. And finally وقوله وهو الغفور الودود. So in these ayat and in these verses that you've all just heard, the author rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions ayat and he mentions verses whereby Allah Azza wa Jal affirms for himself al-mahabba, affirms for himself al-mahabba, his love. And this is a refutation, and these verses are a rad and a refutation ala kulli man sawwa بين المشيئة والمحبة. And these verses are a refutation on those sects that that make a similarity between Allah's mashi'a, Allah's will, and His love, and His love al-mahabba. What does this mean? What this means is that there are a group of sects, or there is a sect known as the Mu'tazila, Al-Mu'tazila Al-Qadariya. They believe that kilahuma mutalaziman, that Allah's will and His mahabba and His love are similar, are the same. Bima'na, everything that Allah Azza wa Jal wills, He also loves automatically. This is what they believe in. We covered this in the previous lesson. So the Mu'tazila Al-Qadariya, they believe that kullu ma shaa Allah faqad ahabbahu. Everything that Allah Azza wa Jal wills, He automatically also loves it. So everything that is happening around us, whether it is kufr, whether it is a ma'asiyah, a sin, whether it is a ta'a, worship, whether it is something mubah, it's, if Allah has willed it and it has happened, then Allah Azza wa Jal, he loves it. And this is the people that believe this are known as the Mu'tazila. The Mu'tazila believe this. And the Mu'tazila believe this, and also the Jabariya, not the Qadariya, sorry, the Jabariya believe this. And we mentioned that this is batil and this is false, because Allah Azza wa Jal may will something, Allah Azza wa Jal may will something to happen, and it doesn't necessarily mean that He loves that thing. So Allah may will something to happen, kawnan, in a, يعني, universally speaking, kawnan, يعني, وقدرًا, but that doesn't mean that Allah loves that thing. So, مثلًا, Allah willed kufr to happen on the earth, but that doesn't mean that Allah loves kufr. وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرَ, Allah Azza wa Jal says. Allah also may will something to happen, and He may love it. Allah willed iman. Allah Azza wa Jal has قدر الإيمان في هذا في هذه الأرض. الله عز وجل قدر وجود المؤمنين في هذه الأرض، فهذا يعني أن الله يحبه. So Allah may will something that is worship to happen, and if it happens, Allah obviously loves it. But this love is connected to His legislative will, not to His universal will. So Allah's mahabba is connected to His legislative will, okay? Not to His, يعني, not necessarily to His universal will. So the reason why the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, is citing these verses is to indirectly refute the Jabariya and the Mu'tazila. So when Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, يعني الإحسان here means if for the person أن يأتي بالعمل على أحسن وجه, that the person comes and does an action in the best possible manner. That's what إحسان means. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, when He says, وَأَحْسِنُوا, يعني أحسنوا في جميع أعمالكم, that you do إحسان in everything that you do. So when you are worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, that you come with ihsan. And ihsan is the highest level, is the highest level of faith, higher than Islam and Iman. And ihsan also encompasses ihsan fi al-mu'amalat ma'al makhluqeen. Ihsan also encompasses to have ihsan and to be just and to fulfill your obligations towards Allah's creation, whether it is to fulfill your obligations to yourself, to fulfill obligations to your spouse, to fulfill obligations to everyone that has a right over you, also to fulfill your obligations to your employer, for example, and tuhsin fi amalik. So ihsan is a term that encompasses everything, and it is a term that encompasses that, يعني, encompasses everything that a person should aspire to whenever they undertake an action or an act that is either ibadah, worship, or is either something that is mubah, something that is permissible, or something that has the level of permissibility, or something that is recommended, or something that is wajib or obligatory. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So وَأَحْسِنُوا, why should we do ihsan? Then Allah يُعَلِّلُ هَذَا. Allah gives the reason. And He says, because Allah loves the muhsineen. Because Allah loves the muhsineen. So as a believer, as a Muslim, there is no doubt that every Muslim aspires to be or to do everything that Allah Azza wa Jalla loves. So if you know that Allah loves the muhsineen, then it is befitting for you to come with ihsan and to do ihsan fi jami'i al-a'mal. When you pray to the best of your ability. When you fast to the best of your ability. When you do something that is يعني considered mubah, or something that is يعني something that serves your community, serves your family, for example, or when you go to work, fulfilling your obligations to your employer, مثلاً, then you do it with the best of your ability. So you come with ihsan fi jami'i al-umur. Na'am. So that's basically what the ayah is referring to. And the ayah clearly affirms al-mahabba lillahi ta'ala. Inna Allah yuhibbu al-muhsineen. And then Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. يعني وَأَقْسِطُوا أو الإقساط هو العدل في المعاملات والأحكام مع القريب والبعيد. So الإقساط is for the person, for you to be just in transactions, in أحكام, in your worship, in your day-to-day worships, in how you deal with the one that is close to you and how you deal with the one that is far away from you. To have iqsat and to do adl with everyone. To be just to the people that you're close to and to be just to the people that you are far, who are not as close to you. People that you don't consider as your loved ones, family or friends. Even to your enemy. Islam even encourages us or even obligates upon us to be just to our enemies. ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى. Allah عز وجل says, يعني just because of your hatred towards the people, let not your hatred and animosity towards the people stop you from being just. ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا. Allah says, be just. Why? هو أقرب للتقوى, because it is closer to taqwa. So Allah Azza wa Jal then يعللو, tells us the reason why we should do iqsat and why we should be just. He says, إن الله يحب المقسطين. Allah Azza wa Jal loves the مقسطين, loves the people who are just. So loves the people that are just in their aqwal, in their words, and they are just in their af'al, in their actions. And this is what Islam encourages us to do. And then he says, وقوله تعالى, فَمَا اسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ فَمَا اسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jal here is speaking about the disbelievers. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, فَمَا اسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ. As long as they are true to their word and they are true to their covenant, they are true to their promise that they made to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ, then be true to them. Fulfill your covenant to them. Fulfill your covenant to them. And again, this is another ayah that clearly illustrates to us the justice and the sumul Islam, the highness of Islam, the akhlaq and the etiquettes of the believers, the high etiquettes of the believers, that we are, Allah Azza wa Jal here is commanding his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be just and to fulfill the rights and the obligations towards the disbelievers. Disbelievers that wanted him to be, yeah, and disbelievers that were out for his blood, subhanAllah. So Allah is saying, فَمَا اسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ. As long as they are true to their covenant and true to their mithaq, true to their aqd, true to their ahd, then فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ. Then you also be true to them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَدِّ الْأَمَانَةَ إِلَى مَنْ اِتَّمَنَكْ وَلَا تَخُنْ مَنْ خَانَكْ. أَدِّ الْأَمَانَةَ, يعني fulfill the amana, fulfill the promise, your amana and your responsibility towards the one who has entrusted you. وَلَا تَخُنْ مَنْ خَانَكْ. And do not betray, do not be treacherous towards the one who betrayed you. So just because a person betrayed you doesn't give you the right to betray them. Be better than them. If a person lied to you, doesn't mean that you also should lie to them. If a person oppressed you in whatever way, that doesn't mean that you should also oppress them. وَلَمَنْ انتصر, however, Allah Azza wa Jal does say in another verse, وَلَمَنْ انتصرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. And whoever seeks aid after being oppressed in the correct manner, then this person, there is no haraj, ma alaykum min sabil, this person has no blame. There's no blame upon them. However, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Whoever forgives and seeks reconciliation, seeks justice or seeks reconciliation, seeks إصلاح, then his ajr and his reward is, inshallah ta'ala, with Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is a daraja and a grade that is better. Darajatu al-afu is better than darajatu al-intisar lil-nafs. نعم. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal loves the Tawwabin. So again, this is another verse that affirms the محبة of Allah Azza wa Jal, that Allah Azza wa Jal loves. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. And التوابين is the plural of التواب. And التوبة linguistically means العودة or الرجوع, to come back. التوبة linguistically means to come back to the truth, to come back to the حق linguistically, or to come back from being in the wrong to being in the right. And شرعا and legislatively, توبة means الرجوع عن الذنب, to come back from a sin, to come back to Allah Azza wa Jal after sinning. Okay, so this التواب in this context is connected to the abd, to the servant. So the servant is commanded to be a tawwab, to be someone who's consistently and persistently making tawbah. يعني someone who always makes tawbah. After sinning, every time they sin, they make tawbah. And even when they don't sin, they make tawbah. So this servant, يتصف بصفة التواب. This servant and this slave of Allah Azza wa Jal who's always making tawbah, على صيغة مبالغة, then we call this person التواب, not التائب. التائب is someone who sometimes makes tawbah. But التواب with يعني the shed on the waw is someone who's always making tawbah. And that's when tawbah is connected to the servant. That's when tawbah is connected to the abd. And Allah Azza wa Jal is tawwab. Allah Azza wa Jal, He is ماذا تواب. So the tawbah of Allah Azza wa Jal is considered, is divided into two. So Allah is also يعني يتصف بصفة التواب أو يتسمى باسم التواب. Allah is also called التواب. Why? Because as Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى says, Ibn al-Qayyim, he says, العبد تواب والله تواب. The servant is تواب. And Allah Azza wa Jal has the name تواب also. So the servant is called تواب. Why? Because he's always making tawbah. And Allah Azza wa Jal is also called, one of his names is At-Tawwab. Why? Ibn al-Qayyim explains and he says, فَتَوْبَةُ الْعَبْدِ رُجُوعُهُ إِلَى سَيِّدِهِ. تَوْبَةُ الْعَبْدِ, the tawbah of the servant, tawbah of the abd, is رُجُوعُهُ إِلَى سَيِّدِهِ, is يعني when the servant goes back to his master, Allah Azza wa Jal. وَتَوْبَةُ اللَّهِ نَوْعَانِ. And the tawbah of Allah Azza wa Jal is two types. إذن وتوفيق وقبول واعتدال. So the tawbah of Allah Azza wa Jal is two types. Or يعني the tawbah of Allah can be divided into two. The first is إذن وتوفيق. The first is إذن وتوفيق. Meaning, number one, that Allah Azza wa Jal first gives you the إذن and the permission to make tawbah. Gives you the tawfiq to make tawbah. Places in your heart the desire to make tawbah. So when this is a ni'mah and a blessing. When Allah Azza wa Jal places in your heart the desire and the will to make tawbah. This is the first type. Okay, the second type or the second type of tawbah that's connected to Allah is qabulun wa'tidad. When Allah accepts your tawbah and rewards you for making tawbah. So in this regard, in this context, from this perspective, Allah is ماذا التواب. Allah is ماذا التواب. So the servant is التواب for continuously and consistently making tawbah, repenting to Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah is tawab for giving the servant the ability and the desire to make tawbah and accepting the tawbah of the servant. Okay? Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, قابل التوب شديد العقاب. قابل التوب. Allah is the one who accepts tawbah. So because Allah accepts tawbah and he's always accepting tawbah, he is tawab. And because the servant is always making tawbah, he is tawab also. But at, so التواب is اسم من أسماء الله تعالى يليق بجلاله وعظمة سلطانه. It is a name that is specific for Allah عز وجل in that regard, in that perspective. I hope that's clear, inshallah. وقوله تعالى, and he says, وقوله تعالى, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Say, إن كنتم تحبون الله. If you truly love Allah, فاتبعوني, then follow me. يعني say, O Muhammad, to these people, if you love Allah, then follow my sunnah. يحببكم الله, Allah will love you. So, and the reason, Ibn al-Kathir رحمه الله تعالى mentioned the reason why this verse was revealed. He says, أن قوما زعموا أنهم يحبون الله فابتلاهم الله. There were a people in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that claimed to love Allah عز وجل. So there were a people that claimed to love Allah عز وجل. They claimed, زعموا, that they love Allah. So Allah عز وجل, he tested them with this verse. And this is why this verse is known as آيات الامتحان. It is an ayah that tests people. So if someone claims to love Allah and doesn't follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then this person clearly does not love Allah azza wa jalla. Because if they did love Allah, they would follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if a person follows the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's a clear indicator that this person loves ماذا? Loves Allah azza wa jalla. So يحببكم الله. يعني if you truly love Allah, then follow my sunnah, and your reward will be that Allah loves you. يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. وقوله تعالى, and then he says, Allah says, فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبونه يحبهم ويحبونه. This part of the verse is connected to قوله تعالى, من يرتد منكم عن دينه. يعني whoever apostates from you, whoever apostates from this religion, فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. يعني الله عز وجل يأتي الله بقوم, he will come with a people, he will create a people that love him and he loves them. Meaning that Allah does not need us. من يعني if every single person on the face of the earth, every single Muslim was to apostate today and leave the fold of Islam, Allah's mulk and his kingdom will not diminish in the slightest. But rather, Allah Azza wa Jalla will replace us with a people that are better than us, who he loves and they love him. So we need Islam. We need Allah Azza wa Jalla, but Allah Azza wa Jalla does not need us. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, huwa al-ghaniyu an ibadihi, huwa al-samad. Huwa al-samad, and we learned al-samad previously. Al-samad, al-kamilu, the most complete. Mastery, power. So in this verse, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ, Allah Azza wa Jal affirms for himself al-mahabba, that he loved, he can love. And he also affirms that his servants also, ماذا? They love him. His servants also love him. And the Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala in the tafasir, he mentions in Allah this verse where Allah Azza wa Jal says Allah يعني يأتي will create a people or will come with a people who love him and they in turn يعني he in turn loves them. Ibn Kathir mentions that this is Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This is referring to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his army from the Sahaba, the Tabi'un, who fought Ahlul Ridda, the apostates. Fought Ahlul Ridda, the apostates. Now, can you all hear me? I think my voice cut out. Okay, Jameel. Now, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. So this is referring to Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه وَجَيْشُهُ الَّذِينَ قَاتَلُوا أَهْلَ الرِّدَّةِ, those who fought the people of Ridda, those who fought the people of apostasy, who apostated after the death of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and when Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه became the Khalifa of the Muslimin. And then وقوله تعالى, Allah's statement, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ في سبيله. إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله. Allah loves those who fight for his cause, fight for his cause in jihad. So Allah loves these people who fight for his cause بأموالهم وأنفسهم, يعني with their wealth and with their lives. So Allah affirms again for himself المحبة, المحبة. And then Allah says وهو الغفور الودود. And Allah عز وجل is الغفور, the one who forgives, who يستر. الغفور is the one who conceals the faults of his servants and his slaves. يعني Allah عز وجل, he forgives them. المغفرة is from الستر. So when Allah عز وجل, when we say اللهم اغفر لنا, we are saying, oh Allah forgive us, oh Allah conceal our faults. استر علينا, conceal our faults. الودود is a level that is higher than محبة. So Allah Azza wa Jalla loves, and also he's also, Allah Azza wa Jalla from his names is Al-Wadud wa huwa Khalisul Mahabba. From his names is Al-Wadud wa huwa Khalis Al-Mahabba. Khalis Al-Mahabba means, يعني Allah Azza wa Jalla, his Mahabba is even greater and purer for some of his slaves, some of his servants, and some of the righteous actions. So الودود وهو خالص المحبة. So all of these آيات فيها إثبات المحبة لله تعالى والمودة. يعني these آيات, these verses, they affirm that Allah عز وجل loves and يود, and he loves in a stronger manner and in a purer manner and in a more powerful way some of his slaves, their righteous actions, and some of the etiquettes and the akhlaq that they come with. So Allah Azza wa Jal loves some things and he hates others. He doesn't love things. So he, if يعني Allah loves الطاعات, he loves worship, he loves righteous people, he loves his servants and his slaves that are righteous. And sometimes he does not love them when they sin. In their state of sinning, he does not love them. When they sin, he does not love them. When they do righteous actions, he loves them. So Allah Azza wa Jal, here he's affirming for himself al-mahabba. And in the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ, هُنَا Allah Azza wa Jal يُثْبِتُ الْمَحَبَّ فِي الْجَانِبَيْنِ, جانب العبد وفي جانب الخالق. Allah Azza wa Jal here, he affirms mahabba and love from the two sides, that the servants love Allah and he also loves them. إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you truly love Allah, so this is coming from the servant to Allah عز وجل, فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ, Allah also, يعني follow me so that Allah loves you. So this is a refutation on the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila, who negate that Allah can be loved, and they negate that Allah loves. So they say in Allah, they say لا يحب ولا يحب. They say that Allah isn't loved, cannot be loved by the servants, and he cannot love as well. So they negate both. So these verses are the reason why Shaykh al-Islam al-Taymiyyah is mentioning these verses to you here, is so that these, يعني, is to refute these people. Because these people, they reject that Allah can love. They also reject and they negate that the servants love him. And when these verses are read to them and recited to them, they say that when Allah, يعني, that they say that the servants here, these verses are not referring to the servant loving Allah, يحبونهم. They say that these verses mean that the servants love their righteous actions that they do for the sake of Allah, which is ta'wil fasid. This is a ta'wil and this is kufr and disbelief. So they say that the servant, he loves his ibadah and his act of worship that he does for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And as for Allah loving them, they say that Allah doesn't love the servants, but when he says yuhibbunahum, Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, is means that Allah Azza wa Jal yuhsinu ilayhim, he is good to them, he is kind to them, he rewards them. So they make ta'wil and tahrif. They make tahrif first and then ta'wil of al-muhabba, of love. And this is clearly batil. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they believe that Allah Azza wa Jal yuhabbu wa yuhibbu. That Allah Azza wa Jal can be loved. The servants love Allah Azza wa Jal directly. They love their righteous actions also, but they also love Allah's ذاته, his essence. And it also means that they also believe that Allah Azza wa Jal loves them. Allah Azza wa Jal can also love, and he loves them in a love that is befitting of his majesty, يَلِيقُ بِجَلَالِهِ وَعَظَمَةِ سُلْطَانِهِ, a love that is befitting of Allah's majesty, and it's a haqiqa, not majaz. So this is basically why the author rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned these verses. Then we move on to the next chapter, which is ithbatu al-rahmati wal-maghfira lillahi ta'ala, which is affirming for Allah Azza wa Jal his rahmah, his mercy, and his maghfira in a manner that is befitting his majesty. So he says, وَقَوْلُهُ, the author says, وَقَوْلُهُ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَقَوْلُهُ رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا وَقَوْلُهُ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا وَقَوْلُهُ وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ وَقَوْلُهُ كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةَ وقوله وهو الغفور الرحيم وقوله فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين وهو أرحم الراحمين. So وقوله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So we covered the basmala in the first lesson, but here in the basmala the two names of Allah, الرحمن and الرحيم, are affirmed for him, and the reason why he's mentioning it here is to teach the student that Allah Azza wa Jal, he is one of his names, or some of his names include Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, and some of his sifat and attributes include Ar-Rahma, which is mercy. And Ar-Rahma is a sifa min sifat Allah Ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, Ar-Rahmanu dalun ala sifat al-qa'ima bihi subhanahu. He says that Ar-Rahman is a name that indicates to the attribute that is an attribute that is established in Allah's that, an attribute of a that. يعني it is an attribute that is connected to Allah direct subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. As-sifa al-qa'ima bihi subhanahu. يعني هذه الصفه تقوم به. It is an attribute of the Allah Azza wa Jal, connected to Allah's that and his essence. And he says, Ibn Qayyim continues, and he says, وَالرَّحِيمُ دَالٌ عَلَىٰ تَعَلُّقِهَا بِالْمَرْحُومِ. And الرحيم, the word, the name الرحيم, is a name that is connected to it. It's a name, and it's a rahmah and a mercy that is connected to those who Allah Azza wa Jal is merciful towards, المرحومين. As Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. Allah did not say, Ibn Qayyim says, وَكَانَ رَحْمَانٌ بِهِمْ. There's no ayah, no hadith where it says Allah is رَحْمَانٌ بِهِمْ. It says وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. Allah Azza wa Jal is ever merciful to his believers, to his mother, to his believers, to the believers. So he's telling us that the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, الرحمن, is a sifa, is a name that is connected to that Allah Ta'ala, to Allah's essence. Whereas the name Ar-Rahim is connected to Allah's, Allah Azza wa Jal's fi'l and his action, his act of being merciful towards his creation. Towards ماذا? His creation. So Ibn al-Qayyim, he then says, وَكَانَ الْأَوَّلُ لِلْوَصْفِ وَالثَّانِي لِلْفِعْلِ. He says the first name, Ar-Rahman, is connected to, وَكَانَ الْأَوَّلُ, he says, لِلْوَصْفِ. The first name is connected to his attribute. The first name, وَكَانَ الْأَوَّلِ, is لِلْوَصْفِ, is an attribute connected to his that. وَالثَّانِي, and the second name, الرَّحِيمِ, is connected to Allah's actions, his fi'l. فَالْأَوَّلُ دَالٌ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الرَّحْمَ وَصْفُهُ. So the first is connected to the fact that Allah's rahmah His mercy, his rahma, his mercy is an attribute of his. والثاني and the second is دال على أنه يرحم خلقه برحمته. Is connected to the fact that Allah عز وجل يرحم خلقه. He is merciful towards his creation with برحمته with his mercy. برحمته with his mercy. طيب. Then he says, ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما. So this verse is speaking about the angels. يعني the angels who carry عرش الرحمن. يعني if you look at the سياق and the context of this verse, the angels, they يحملون العرش ومن حوله ويستغفرون للمؤمنين. يعني they carry Allah's throne. Okay? And they make استغفار and they seek forgiveness for the believers. And then they say, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. They say, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Oh Allah, you have encompassed everything with your rahmah and your knowledge, with your mercy and your knowledge. So Allah's rahmah here, this is a clear دليل and a proof that Allah's rahmah encompasses everything. رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً. So Allah Azza wa Jal here, يعني the ayah is teaching us that Allah is merciful towards everything. Everything has touched Allah. Allah's mercy has touched everything. The believer, the non-believer. The fajr, the kafir, everyone. Iblis himself and the shayateen are also يتمتعون. They are also benefiting from Allah's mercy. وَرَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا. However, Allah Azza wa Jal on يوم القيامة, His mercy is going to be specific to ماذا? To the believers. And then he says, وَقَوْلُهُ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. Allah Azza wa Jal, He is Rahim and merciful towards the believers. He is merciful towards them in the dunya and in the akhirah. In the dunya, He's merciful towards them because Allah Azza wa Jal هَدَاهُمْ إِلَى الْحَقِّ. Allah Azza wa Jal هَدَاهُمْ إِلَى الْحَقِّ. He has guided them to the truth. He, because of, يعني he's merciful towards them in the dunya because he has guided them to the truth. And in the akhirah, he's merciful towards them لأنه آمنهم من الفزع الأكبر. Allah Azza wa Jal is merciful towards them because he has granted them safety and security from the, يعني from the anguish and from the fear from the terrors of يوم القيامة, from the فزع الأكبر, from the major terrors of يوم القيامة, and these فزع, this terror and the hole and the horrors يعني that will happen on يوم القيامة, they will happen to the disbelievers, but as for the believers, they will be safe and secure, and Allah will grant them safety and security from those horrors. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. يعني Allah Azza wa Jal أوجب على نفسه. He has obligated upon himself الرحمة. Allah has made it obligatory upon himself to be merciful. And this is an obligation that Allah has made upon himself. No one else has made this obligatory upon him. He, بِفَضْلِهِ وَكَرَمِهِ وَإِحْسَانِهِ, he has made this obligatory upon himself, يعني because of his karam, because of his generosity, his ihsan, his goodwill, his mercy, he has made it obligatory upon himself, kawnan wa qadaran, يعني in universally speaking, from a universal perspective, from يعني through his universal will, he has made it obligatory upon himself to be ماذا? To be merciful. وهو الغفور الرحيم. وهو الغفور الرحيم. فيها هنا إثبات المغفرة والرحمة. And Allah Azza wa Jal is al-ghafoor. He is the most forgiving. He is ماذا? The most forgiving. And al-rahim, he is the most ماذا? Merciful. وقوله تعالى فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحم. فالله خير حافظا. يعقوب, when the sons of Ya'qub, they ask their father Ya'qub to allow them to take Yusuf with them. To allow them in order for Yusuf, his son, his favorite son, to accompany them. He was, and they said that we will protect him. They said, we will protect him. He was Yaqub, he said, فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا. يعني Allah is a better protector. Allah عز وجل is ماذا? Is a better protector. And he entrusted Yusuf to Allah عز وجل. So in this verse, فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا, يعني Allah عز وجل here, he affirms for himself that he is the one who protects. He is the one who protects. And from the names of Allah عز وجل is Al-Hafidh. Is Al-Hafidh, the one who protects. So these verses, they affirm for Allah عز وجل Al-Rahmah, mercy, Al-Maghfirah, the fact that he is the most forgiving. And this is a clear refutation upon the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila, who deny the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal, who reject and negate the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal and His maghfirah. And they say that Allah Azza wa Jal cannot be rahim. He cannot have mercy, because if He does have mercy, then this is a tashbih, and this resembles the mercy of the creation. This resembles ماذا? The mercy of the creation. So they say that if we affirm for Allah al-Rahmah, then we are claiming, and we are in essence, this is what they say, we are claiming that Allah is similar to the creation. So because of this, they say that Allah Azza wa Jalla yattasifu ماذا bil-Rahmah. And some of them, they say that the verses that affirm for Allah al-Rahmah are majaz. They are not haqiq, they are metaphorical. They are ماذا metaphorical. And others they say that these verses, when Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ الرَّحِيمَ, or any verse that affirms for Allah al-Rahmah, then this verse is affirming, is alluding to the fact that Allah Azza wa Jal is muhsinun ilayhim. Allah Azza wa Jal is good to his servants, or Allah Azza wa Jal is kind to them. So they actually contradict themselves. So they are affirming for Allah ihsan, which they actually negate anyway. They affirm in the verses of Rahmah, they affirm for Allah kindness, and they affirm for Allah the fact that He is good to His servants. But they are, and at the same time, they are negating Rahmah. They are negating Rahmah itself, the Sifat al-Rahmah, the mercy. And the reason they're negating the Sifat al-Rahmah is because the servants and the slaves and the makhluqeen also have Rahmah. So Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said to them, but the servants also can be kind. They can also be good. So your tafsir of Rahmah, whatever you make tafsir of Rahmah with, is also applies to the creation. If that means, it also applies to the creation. And then that's why some of them, they said, okay, in that case, then it's majaz. It's ماذا majaz. We say that the Rahmah here is not actual Rahmah. It's majaz. So Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah said to them, what does rahmah here mean? Yani, can there be something in the Quran that we don't know the meaning of? So as you can see, Ahlul Batil daiman yatanaqadun. Yani, the people of Batil and falsehood, they are always contradicting themselves. Whereas Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah, because their source is the haqq and the truth, and they're upon the haqq, they never, alhamdulillah, contradict themselves. And we, Ahlul Sunnah also, refute the Mu'tazila and the Jahmiyyah بقوله تعالى ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Allah عز وجل says ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing that is similar to Allah عز وجل. يعني Allah عز وجل, He is called الرحيم, الرحمن, الملك, القدوس, Allah. He has all of these beautiful names, but none of the names of Allah are names that are equal or the same. يعني that these names are names that are specific to Allah Azza wa Jal, meaning that Allah Azza wa Jal has these names and has these sifat, these attributes. And these attributes are attributes that are befitting Allah's majesty. They are befitting Allah's majesty. So some of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal are equal. يعني some of the names of Allah, as Shaykh Sanan Taymi mentions, are similar to the names of the creation. They're similar to ماذا? To the names of the creation. And they're similar in words only. They are similar in the word only, but not in the reality, not in the haqiqa and reality. So, مثلاً, يعني, the servant, a slave, can be described as Rahim, as merciful. يعني you can describe so and so is merciful, but so and so's mercy is always a mercy that is naqis, a deficient. Whereas the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla is a mercy that is complete, befitting of His majesty, befitting of His power, befitting of His status and stature. And the servant's rahmah is befitting of their limited status. So a servant, you can be merciful, but no matter how merciful you are, your mercy cannot reach everyone. It can't even reach your whole family. You can be merciful, مثلاً, to your loved one, to your son or to your daughter. Your son or your daughter can be sick one day. You're merciful towards them, but your mercy cannot cause them to become, يعني, to become cured. Your mercy cannot treat them. Whereas Allah Azza wa Jalla's mercy can cause the person to become to be treated or to be cured. So Allah's mercy touches everything. You may want everyone to be rich, but you can't make everyone rich. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, His mercy is a mercy that is more, that is most complete. Naam. So this is how, this is just one of the ways that we can refute the people, these, the Jahmiya and the Mu'tazila. And inshallah ta'ala, we will stop here. نقف عند هذا الحد. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. If anyone has any questions regarding what we've just studied, then you can ask now, inshallah ta'ala. Otherwise, we will end the session there. If you need to go now, you can, inshallah ta'ala, go. Okay, so someone's asking, what's the ruling? What's the ruling on thinking Allah maybe isn't happy with you due to sins, even if you feel your good deeds outweigh the bad? This must be from Shaitan, right? Firstly, awwalan, for someone if we have sinned, then it is upon us to make tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Nastaghfirullah ta'ala wa natubu ilayhi. And if we commit a sin, then we know that Allah isn't happy with us. Okay, we know that Allah Azza wa Jalla isn't happy with us. And this is a good, this is the correct way, this is what you should be feeling. This, because one of the conditions of a tawbah is a nadam ala dhanb, is a nadam to regret and to feel sorrowful and to feel bad for what you have done. Okay, this is one of the shurut and the conditions of the acceptance of tawbah. And even if you feel that your good deeds outweigh your bad ones, then you don't know if your good deeds have been accepted. You don't know if your good deeds have been accepted. We do righteous actions, we pray, but we don't know for certain that Allah Azza wa Jalla has even accepted them. We hope that Allah has accepted them. نُحْسِنُ الظَّنَّ بِرَبِّنَا. We have ihsan al-dhan. We have good suspicions and thoughts about Allah Azza wa Jalla. But we don't assume that automatically, that just because we've worshipped Allah Azza wa Jalla, or we've come with an act of obedience, we don't assume automatically that it has been accepted. With that being said, the Salaf rahimahumullah ta'ala, they say that al-abdu fi hal as-sihhati wa al-rakha yughallib janib al-raja' wa fi hal al-khawf wal-marad wal-da'f yughallib عفوا في حال الصحة والرخاء يغلب نعم يغلب جانب الخوف وفي حال الرخاء وفي حال الخوف والمرض والضعف يغلب جانب الرجاء. This, the Salaf, they say that in this, when the servant is in a state of health and they are in a state of يعني being healthy, they are in يعني they are in prosperity. Then the servant should always, يعني يغلب, should put more emphasis on the fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla, should be more fearful of Allah Azza wa Jalla in that state. But when the servant is in a state of weakness, when they're sick, when they're ill, then in that state they should put more emphasis on hope, and that they should always have hope for the best from Allah Azza wa Jalla. So when the servant is in their deathbed and they're dying or they're sick, really sick, in that state, then it is legislated that that person should remember all the good deeds that they did, and the people around them should give them hope and raja in the Allah's maghfirah and rahmah in that state. This is the sunnah, inshallah ta'ala, with regards to this. What are the signs of accepted tawbah? If a person has followed all the conditions of correct tawbah, should they perform tawbah for the major sin once, or should they continue doing tawbah for the same sin until the end of their life? Na'am. So firstly, there are tawbah has certain conditions. From the conditions of a tawbah is al-ikhlas, that you're sincere, you make tawbah sincerely for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. From the conditions of a tawbah is an-nadam ala ma fat, is that you are regretful for what you have done, for the sin that you've committed. From the conditions of a tawbah is al-iqla' an al-dhanb, that you desist from continuing that sin, you stop committing that sin. From the conditions of a tawbah, number four is al-azimatu ala an la ta'ud ila hadha al-dhanb, that you have azima and you have you strong conviction that you'll never return to that sin. If you come and if the tawbah, if the sin is connected to a creation, to the servants, that you've wronged someone, you've oppressed them, then you have to fulfill and you have to give back their rights. You have to give them back their rights. If you've taken some wealth from them, you have to give it back to them. You have to seek forgiveness from those people that you have wronged. If all of these conditions are met, if all these conditions are if now. If all these conditions, if all these conditions are met, the person should be hopeful that Allah Azza wa Jal accepts their tawbah. Should be hopeful for the best that Allah Azza wa Jal accepts their tawbah. And the ulama rahimahumullah ta'ala, they say that tawbah, a person should continuously make istighfar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam كان يستغفر الله تعالى ويتوب إليه في اليوم أكثر من 100 مرة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make istighfar, and he used to seek forgiveness. He used to seek forgiveness and make tawbah in a day more than 100 times. And this is the Prophet of Islam sallallahu alaihi wasallam. الذي غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. يعني all of his previous sins were forgiven. The Prophet's sins were all forgiven. Yet the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to seek forgiveness more than 100 times in a day. Subhanallah. So with that being said, we should نعود لساننا. We should continuously نستغفر الله تعالى. We should make a habit to make tawbah to Allah عز وجل, even if you haven't sinned, because you may have sinned. يعني you don't know, and once if you pray, مثلاً, if you pray, نعم. If you مثلا pray your daily prayers, if you pray your daily prayers, then you don't know if that prayer, if you've مثلا every time you tasu, every time you think of or you don't have proper khushu', then يعني it is a shortcoming on your part. So this is why it is legislated that we say astaghfirullah three times. We say astaghfirullah three times. After يعني, or continuously after we pray, or should they continue doing tawbah for the same sin until the end of their life? نعم, يعني you can continue تحسن الظن بربك, يعني you don't have to continue making tawbah, be remorseful, be regretful for the sin that you have committed, while at the same time always assuming that the best and always having good thoughts and suspicions of Allah Azza wa Jalla, that Allah inshallah ta'ala will accept your tawbah. So you have to come with that balance. You have to ماذا? Come with that balance between al-khawf wal-raja. يعني the Ahlus Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, they worship Allah Azza wa Jalla with khawf, with raja, and with mahabba. يعني they worship Allah Azza wa Jalla with fear, they worship Allah with hope, and they worship Allah with love. And These three acts of worship are like the head and the two wings of a bird. A bird cannot fly except if it has mahabba, except if it has mahabba, يعني if it has love, fear, يعني if it has a bird cannot fly except if it has wings, two wings and a head. Similarly, a servant cannot worship Allah Azza wa Jal except with mahabba, by loving Allah, by hoping for Allah Azza wa Jal, يعني hoping for the best, and by at the same time having rahmah, by and also at the same time having يعني يعني having khawf and raja, having hope, hoping for the best from Allah Azza wa Jal, hoping that Allah accepts their sin, accepts the acts of worship, and at the same time fearing that Allah, fearing Allah's punishment. Whereas the Khawarij, مثلاً, the Khawarij, they worship Allah Azza wa Jal only with khawf, only with khawf, with fear. Whereas the Murji'ah, they worship Allah only with raja, only with hope. And the Sufiyah, they worship Allah only with mahabba. They worship Allah only with ماذا? With mahabba. And Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they worship Allah with khawf, raja, and mahabba. So you should come with that balance, inshallah ta'ala. Next question. Now, if you've passed, if the exam has passed, inshallah ta'ala, inshallah, some of you are emailing regarding the exam. Can we do the exam again, the same exam? I think the exam, the deadline has passed. Inshallah, the next time, inshallah, just do the exam for the, and then the next exam, try to make it for the next exam, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. أحسن الله إليك. I feel as though my tawbah is superficial, so how can I make it more meaningful? What do you mean by superficial? Alhamdulillah, we know the conditions of tawbah. So we know ماذا the conditions of tawbah. We know that the conditions of tawbah, as mentioned, there are four or five conditions of tawbah. If you come with those conditions of tawbah and you are sincere in your tawbah, and you're truly regretful, because the Prophet ﷺ summarized the whole of Tawbah to be a nadam. He said, a nadamu Tawbah. Nadam, being regretful. The moment you feel regretful, you regret your actions, what you've done, that is a sign of Tawbah. That is a good sign. That is a sign that your Tawbah, inshallah ta'ala, will be accepted. Bi'indhillah ta'ala. It doesn't mean that you should go back to the sin. It means that once you have that regret, it doesn't give you a license, khalas, I have the regret now and I'm going to go back to that same sin. No, abadan. Once you have that regret in your heart and you have the firm conviction that you're not going to go back to it, and it's sincerely for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, then this is a good sign that your tawbah, inshallah ta'ala, will be accepted. A good sign. No, نحن لا نجزم. We can't say with firm conviction that an act of worship will be accepted from us. So, مثلا, we do acts of worship. نحن نحسن. وقل اعملوا, Allah says. وقل اعملوا فسيرى الله عملكم ورسوله والمؤمنون. Allah says, do righteous actions. Upon us is to do the righteous action. But as for the acceptance of that righteous action, that is Allah's Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal, He's the one who accepts or rejects. It is Allah's decision at the end of the day. We do what we can and we hope for the best. Okay? So, come with all of these conditions of tawbah, and bi'idhnillah ta'ala, your tawbah will be accepted. And at the same time, beware of being muwaswisun. Beware of waswas. Do not become prey to the whisperings of the shaitan. Because the shaitan wants you to become, to despair of Allah's mercy. He wants you to despair of Allah's mercy. The shaitan wants to make you believe and think that your tawbah will never be accepted. Or even if you do make tawbah, that your tawbah wasn't accepted. Because once you reach this level of despair, and this level of qunut, and rahmatillahi ta'ala, or al-ya'su min rawhillahi ta'ala, once you reach this can actually lead to kufr and disbelief. And Sheikh Muhammad al-Wahhab has a chapter on this in Kitab al-Tawheed. And this is very, very dangerous, because then you are cutting off all hope in your heart that Allah Azza wa Jal can be merciful towards you. And once that happens, then the shaitan will tempt you to continue making sins and continue to sin, because then the shaitan will say, what's the point of repenting to Allah? He won't accept your repentance. You've committed too many sins. You've done too many bad things. Your tawbah will never be accepted. And then the person, the servant, will not make tawbah. And then your tawbah, you're 100% sure that if you don't make tawbah, your tawbah won't be accepted. But inshallah ta'ala, there is a chance, a good chance, if you make tawbah for your tawbah to be accepted. So logically speaking, isn't it better to make tawbah? Of course it is. Because if you don't make tawbah, 100% you're sure your tawbah won't be accepted because there was no tawbah in the first place. But if you do make tawbah, then your tawbah, inshallah ta'ala, will be accepted. So نحن نحسن الظن بربنا. And we have ihsan al-dhan and we have good suspicions of our Lord, inshallah ta'ala. What's the difference between al-maghfirah and al-afu? Al-maghfirah huwa al-sitru. Al-maghfirah huwa ماذا؟ ماذا؟ Al-sitru. Al-maghfirah means, as mentioned, is for Allah Azza wa Jal to hide and to conceal your sins from the creation. To conceal your sins. So Allah, that sin remains between you and Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah doesn't expose you. So when you're saying Allahumma ighfir li, you're saying, oh Allah, don't expose me. La tafdahni, don't expose me. Allahumma astur alayya, oh Allah, conceal my sins. And al-afu, inna Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make dua, akthar ma kana yad'u bi qawlihi, inna Allah, Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anni. Al-afu is to forgive you for, you're asking Allah to forgive you for your shortcomings in your worship, in acts of worship. Okay, al-afu also means to, you're asking Allah to forgive you for sins as well. But also, al-afu is connected to shortcomings, our shortcomings towards Allah, our obligations towards Allah Azza wa Jal. Our shortcomings when it comes to our obligation towards Allah Azza wa Jal. So we have shortcomings when we fast. We don't fast in a manner that is truly what Allah wanted. So نحن, we ask Allah for afu. We don't pray in a manner that is truly how Allah wanted. When we pray, we don't have khushu'. We pray quickly. We sometimes don't even pray on time. Okay? So when we finish, we say, Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Okay? If a person makes tawbah from a sin, will they still be questioned about it on the day of judgment? No. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lahu. When he says, At-tawbatu tajubbu ma qablaha. At-ta'ibu min al-dhanb. The one who has made tawbah from a sin is as though they have not even and never committed that sin. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, At-tawbatu tawbah or repentance, tajubbu ma qablaha, wipes away everything that preceded it. Wipes away everything that preceded it. If a person always tries to give the rights of people for the sake of Allah, but people are unjust to them and misinterpret it as being in need of them, should the person at one point stop doing this if continuing is becoming hard? يعني, this goes back to who this person is. If these people are your family, مثلا, people that you're entrusted towards, people that rely upon you, and يعني, then continue doing what you're doing. Continue, inshallah ta'ala, if they're your family members, continue helping them for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. يعني, as Allah Azza wa Jal, يعني, he mentioned some of the, from the sifat of the believers, that يعني, إنما نو, they say from the believers, they say, إنما نطعمكم لوجه الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. We feed you for the sake of Allah, لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. We do not want from you جزاء, a reward, ولا شكورا, and we do not want from you شكورا, يعني, a gratitude. We're not looking for gratitude. So when you're helping people and you're giving for the sake of Allah, whether it's giving your wealth or your time, you're giving in charity, then do it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal and don't seek any reward from them. Don't seek even a thank you from them because you're doing it, your jaza is with Allah Azza wa Jal. Your reward, inshallah ta'ala, is with Allah Azza wa Jal. And do as much as you can. If you reach a point where يعني, it's difficult for you to continue due to يعني, other factors, then يعني, this is an ihsan from your end. This is an ihsan and a tafaddul from your end. meaning that يعني this is not obligatory upon you. You can stop whenever you can, يعني whenever you want, whenever ماذا you want. نعم, is it enough to make توبة generally like all you did before you started practicing, or do you have to do to remember each sin and make توبة for it? If you remember each sin, make توبة for it. If you don't, then make a general توبة. اللهم إني أستغفرك وأتوب إليك من جميع الذنوب والمعاصي. Oh Allah, I seek your forgiveness and I seek توبة, and I'm making توبة from all of my sins, my previous sins, and all of the sins that I committed, the ones that I know of and the ones that I do not know of, the ones that I did secretly, the ones that I did publicly. So make that type of tawbah and make that type of istighfar in Allah Ta'ala. But if you know the specific sin, then you say, Allahumma inni astaghfiruka min hadha al-dhanb. Oh Allah, I seek forgiveness from this particular sin. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us our sins. نسأل الله تعالى أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا جميعا وأن يتوب علينا إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وقل رب زدني علما.